My name is Paul.
What kind of people they seem to be, son?
I bet they're spies.
We will forget we are Jews.
My bar mitzvah. I want to see a rabbi about it.
He is talking nonsense.
Come.
We will go home.
No!
You say no to your father, have you no respect?
I wonder if the kid feels like he's free in America and he's interpreting their experience differently than his parents are.
Mm-hmm. They don't trust anybody. The kid is innocent.
Paul has his freedom of religion to practice whatever religion he chooses in this country.
The parents are probably more traumatized.
100%.
And they've done their best to shelter Paul, probably back in Germany when these crazy acts were happening, throwing bricks into buildings and overall terrorizing Jewish communities.
Not ever.
Come on, Paul, be sensible.
The Jews weren't allowed to have government jobs at this point. So if you're a postal worker or you worked in city government, you essentially got expelled if you were Jewish. Paul just fell into Drusilla Pond. Oh, Grandpa drinking from his saucer.
Oh, that's one of my favorites.
Yep.
Here, let me take that.
It's bootleg whiskey.
I don't think it's bootleg.
If the recipe tasted like this, it'd be pretty good, right?
By morning, he'll be right as rain.
Is this whiskey a sponsor of the show?
We have no sponsors.
It could become one, though.
Maybe a future sponsor.
We're like a Planet Nine of a podcast. We're floating out in the ether.
Like a little boy again.
The movie Planet Nine from Outer Space?
No, it's just, we're
just Planet Nine, okay.
Planet X, some people call it.
Well, I don't accept that.
I remember hearing about Planet X in elementary school.
Being a mysterious planet hanging out there. It's crazy they haven't found it.
I thought it was cool because it's just like a letter.
And it's floating out there and it's affecting Neptune and Uranus's orbits.
Uranus?
They're looking for this thing that's tugging on Uranus's orbit.
Ah. Sick.
That's fine. Virginia whiskey, folks, once again.
Courage and conviction.
Does the Waltons podcast go to outer space in the future? Is that in the works?
That's like the third reboot.
That's something that John writes, maybe, in the future.
John Boy writes about going to space.
Well, it's like there's a probe that gets sent out to the moon, and they found that there's a mountain range that totally duplicates Walton's mountain.
Okay.
Everything is the same. Wow. So they say, we need the Waltons to relocate to the moon.
What?
So we totally missed that last part.
The first day we arrived, someone threw a rock to our window.
That's an accident, I'm sure.
Yeah.
but we're saving the human race.
Yeah, but here's Grandpa. This is the big crux of the episode.
If you see Grandpa, everybody shut the f*** up.
Has Grandpa weighed in on the Jew-German stuff?
I think you're going to see it right now, Ian.
Oh, Goethe.
Mint.
Oh, Dankeschön. David, did you hear that?
Yes, I heard. Excuse me, I have some work to do.
Just a minute, Professor. I'd like to have a word or two with you.
David.
I haven't finished yet, Professor.
Please listen to him. He is older. Can you take a seat, Mr. Walton?
I thank you.
He is older.
He's older.
Yep. He should sit down.
I think you ought to know that my two young grandchildren broke your window accidentally with their slingshot. And they are sorry for it. And what's more, they are going to pay for it. And then, too, perhaps I don't understand what you feel or you've been through because I am not of your faith. But there is one thing that I do understand. Doesn't matter what your color or your religion is, you got to be proud of your heritage and stand up to it like a man. You're not ashamed of being a Jew, are you?
It is not a question of shame. It is a question of survival.
Well, suppose you do survive on the outside. Inside, you die. Your own son, he won't come home to you. And you yourself, sir, I do believe that you are not a happy man. You see, sir, I was born here in the shadow of this mountain. My father before that and his father before that. And there are just generations of us Waltons buried up here on the hill.
Along with the Native Americans we killed.
I wonder what... the Mann family has heard about America, where maybe they know about the past of the Civil War and the Native American.
My grandchildren wouldn't be what they are today. I know that same sort of feeling is deep in your heart. Just like it's been in the hearts of all your people for over 5,000 years.
Thank you, Mr. Walton.
But it's got to speak well for America that they decided to come here, of all places.
Mm-hmm. And I think people all around the world really liked Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah.
So
Republican.
Back in the day, Republican, yes. Yes.
Grand old party.
Mama.
I'm going to start wearing nightgowns like that.
So here we have confirmation that Paul stayed the night at the Waltons. We don't know who got put out. Whose bed is that?
This is John Boy's room.
I don't think it is. It might be one of the boys' room.
They share a room. All three of them.
No, John Boy gets his own room. And
then Jason, yes, the other boys share.
Jason, Ben, and Jim Bob, the three of them are together.
Right.
So whose bed is that?
It's always John Boy's bed.
I'm telling you, I think...
Oh, you think he's staying with the boys?
Yeah.
He's so where does Jason go?
Floor.
I think it's John Boy's room.
Let us know in the comments.
Whose room was that?
Whose bed was that? Whose room was
it
that?
It was John Boy's. I don't need a confirmation. Don't write in the comments. We already know.
This guy with the swearing. Join us next time for the finale of The Ceremony, only on The Recipe, The Waltons Podcast.